If you have pelvic pain, what I'm going to say here today, I believe, is very important. Pelvic pain is both a systemic and local problem. It's a systemic problem in that the nervous system, which is often chronically near an emergency state, typically tightens up the pelvic muscles, often for many years. It's a local problem in that the chronic worry, anxiety, and nervous arousal in certain individuals results in tension in the pelvic muscles on a chronic basis. Conventional treatment tends to miss the big picture of the systemic relationship to the local and ultimately offers little help to either facet. To address only the local problem is short-sighted and insufficient, similar to removing an alcoholic's access to alcohol without also addressing what initially drove the alcoholic to drink. Simply treating the symptoms of pelvic pain while disregarding the underlying cause is woefully inadequate and at best a short-term solution. Relief from pelvic pain with its often bewildering and troubling symptoms is what those who are seeking help for pelvic pain are looking for. However, pelvic pain, while undeniably distressing, is merely the last event in a series of events that occurs in someone's life. Without addressing and resolving what led to the pelvic pain, any relief of the pelvic pain is temporary and ultimately ineffective. It's not a real solution. I say this from someone who had pelvic pain for 22 years and no longer has it, so I've been through it myself personally. Prior to the occurrence of pelvic pain, in a large number of our patients, there is typically a pattern of chronic worrying, anxiety, and emotional distress that has caused the pelvic floor to tighten up, usually this occurring over many years. This chronic heightened nervous system arousal is typically the root of the dysfunction of the muscles in the pelvis because the muscles have been tightened up to a point where they don't function properly. Some people are unaware of their anxious state. We've seen patients who have said something to the effect of, "I'm not anxious, even though I worry all the time." As the saying goes, when you're in water all the time, you don't even know you're wet. Likewise, when you live day in and day out in certain levels of anxiety and chronic nervous arousal, it can feel normal, and you don't realize how chronically tense you are. Most people certainly miss how this intimately and directly affects the muscles in and around their pelvis. You just don't feel it. You don't know that your anxiety is continually and intimately tightening up your pelvic floor. This is why it's essential to both identify and treat pelvic pain as what it is, both systemic and local dysfunction. It's not enough to focus only on one or the other. Physical therapy alone, for instance, even if it's done well and with an adequate number of sessions, for instance, is typically an inadequate treatment, in my experience, because it does not deal with a systemic aspect of the problem, only the local one. In the same vein, psychotherapy and stress reduction, without resolving the chronically painful and tightened pelvic floor, while sometimes a better strategy than focusing only on the physical part of the problem, is still an incomplete treatment. Both meaningfully and centrally addressing the systemic and the local aspects of pelvic pain is necessary in order to have any kind of real chance of resolving the kind of pelvic pain, certainly, that we treat. To this end, our six-day clinic trains our patients in the most advanced internal and external physical therapy self-treatment, training them to use our FDA-approved internal trigger point wand, and training them in the remarkable relaxation protocol called paradoxical relaxation that we have used and developed over the years. I hope this is a helpful talk for you.